Hey, horse people. Been getting a lot of questions about duct tape on a horse. Does it work? So the theory is, you put duct tape on a horse and it'll keep him distracted. So this is a Pacific Horseshoer's
stand still for mama now.
Gag on this.
Barrier. Come on now. There we go, little baby spot. There we go. Oh.
So this is how you use duct tape to help a horse stand still.
Hi, I'm Bob Smith. I own Pacific Coast Horseshoeing School. The duct tape to calm the horse has been going all over the internet and Facebook. And we've got our own little method of doing it here at Pacific Coast Horseshoeing School. So let's see how it works on this particular horse. Duct tape, please.
You stand still for the good little horse. Hey. You stand
still. This dude's my hero. All right. So, great skit there, Pacific Horseshoeing. I've always said a million times, people, shut up when you're handling a horse. There ain't nothing worse than somebody stand there, and you're just making a horse irritated. Now, actually, distracting a horse with your voice can help if you can keep him focused on one thing. So, the duct tape thing, and there was a couple of videos in here that I saw that kind of looked like this one was these people are trying to do this syringe thing, and they're chasing this horse around trying to say without duct tape it's hard. See her reaching, see her pulling, see her tugging. That's when I say trainers can make a horse look bad. See how she's not really working with the horse and she's just trying to make it move. So, and then of course when they put the duct tape on, they're doing it more slowly and oh magic, look, the duct tape works. Alright, this one right here, actually I was kind of going to dog on this farrier, but he actually was being pretty patient with this horse. This horse is moving. There's a lot of noise going on. Horse obviously hasn't been tied. I don't know if he's hurt, if he's scared of this farrier, if this farrier has hurt him, if he's never been shooed. Whatever the issue is, this horse is definitely not being too cooperative. Now, he almost gets the horse here, and the horse ends up moving. So let me give you the theory on this. While he's doing this in the background, you can watch his horse jump around. The theory behind the duct tape thing is the horse, if you put duct tape on a horse's nose, now, and again, I don't really like this because when you pull it off, you're pulling hair. But if you have to get emergency treatment and it happens to work, well then, you know what? If it works, then do it. So he's going to put some duct tape on this horse's nose and you're going to notice the horse is going to be focused on the duct tape because there's something stuck to his nose that he can't see. And he kind of goes into freeze or flight. When I talk about fight or flight mode, there's also freeze mode. Some animals, will, like deer and stuff, will freeze when they're in fight or flight. So fight or flight is actually fight, flight, or freeze. And if you go into a panic, sometimes you freeze. So he stuck this duct tape on his horse's nose. So it's pulling. As the horse moves, it's pulling his nose. It's flapping. It's loose. The horse sees something on the front of his face. He doesn't know what it is. You can see the horse is a little confused here, and he's really not understanding what's going on. The horse has kind of got his ears to the guy, but he's also kind of like, what the hell's on my nose? And the guy picks up the hoof, he bangs on it, and the horse doesn't move after he does this. Now, did he change? I think he changed a little bit. He wasn't being quite as noisy, but that's kind of the theory behind this. This duct tape, you know, when you use duct tape, if you want to use duct tape, again, it's going to pull and it's going to hurt the horse, but if it's the only thing that you can do that gets your horse calmed down, it can possibly work. Now, if you get duct tape on there and you've got somebody going, oh, coochie, coochie, you want a cookie, boo, 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 and you and they're rubbing their face and they're rubbing their ear and they're doing 10 other things, then the horse can get over saturated with so much distraction that it'll panic and run and do more. So just the duct tape to keep the horse occupied, I guess it's feasible, it work. Have I ever done it? No. Would I do it? Probably not. I think there's other ways you can work with a horse. But I'm getting a lot of questions about it. What do you think? Is it true? Should it work? Rick, what do you think? Is it mean? Look, I mean, it's going to hurt the horse a little bit when you pull the hair off. I think there's a better way, but hey, to each his own. You know, I give my opinion and my advice, and then people can do what they want. All right, so that's the duct tape, my theory and my input on the duct tape. Pacific Coast horseshoe and duct tape, I really like that idea, and I really think that will work better than putting it on a horse's nose. All right, well, on that there, buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.